Every day we eat a certain amount of sugar, but you might have rarely seen a sugar burn under a normal condition. Today, with the help of Chemistry of Monsters set by Melt Chemistry, we will try to ignite it. Do not forget to put on protective goggles before the experiment. And also conduct all the experiments on a plastic tray. For this experiment, take the solar fuel stove from your starter kit and put a piece of foil onto it to avoid any possible pollution of the stove. The three sugar cubes as shown in the video and try to ignite them. You will notice that the sugar cubes don't burn, but can only melt. So we will need a catalyst to make sugar catch on fire. To prepare the catalyst, take some paper and burn it on the stove. Rub the obtained ash on all sides of the surface of one of the sugar cube. The ashes contain carbonates of different metals, such as the salts of carbonic acid. These substances act as accelerators of the reaction of sugar burning, and we call them as catalysts of the reaction. The sugar cube, which is covered with ashes, will now burn. The catalyst makes possible for the process to take place, because without the help of the catalyst, will the reaction proceed too slowly. The products of the complete sugar burning are carbon dioxide and water, while the products of the incomplete oxidation are complicated organic compounds, aldehydes, ketones, and carboxylic acids, which are left as black mass. If you want to learn more about this experiment, please visit our Melt Chemistry website.